An entry to Robert's On My Turntable 4-year anniversary contest. Hi, my own community, it's Morten here, and I thought I would take the opportunity that has been afforded to me by watching various videos in the VC to enter Robert's contest. His contest is to celebrate, like I said, him being part of the Vinyl community for 4 years now. I have been watching some of his videos over the past few little while, and I was made aware of the contest through, was it JC or Christian, maybe? Or maybe someone else, I'm not entirely sure right now. The contest is as follows. Show four of your favorite bands and their this band's fourth album. Should be easy enough, although having waited a few days, some of those artists have already, and albums obviously, have already been picked. So I thought, well, I better dig a little deeper then, and I came up with as follows. First out, it's Smashing Pumpkins. Yes, it's Adore, an album that I adore. Oh, wow, advanced humor. Yep, I got my window in front of me, as you can see. That'll do it. Their fourth album, not the big seller, perhaps after the success of Melancholy and other their previous albums, but I love it. A foray or move into more electronica. And I remember it well, the time that I was listening to this. So, end of the 90s, I was moving back and forth between Copenhagen and a few places. I made some friends online in chat programs that were living in the US. I even went to visit some of them. So yeah, it's an album that I have fond memories of, and it has a special mood to it, I think. Next up. I'm just cheating a little bit here. Next up, I would do, yeah, from Blackwood Caerphilly in Wales. My heroes, Manic Street Preachers, their fourth album, Everything Must Go. And this is the box version. So after three albums, they were going on tour, and James Bradfield, Sean Moore, Nicky Wire were all set to go on a tour to the US, and their fourth member, Richie Edwards, he did not show up, and he has not been seen since. Richie didn't do much as far musically for the band, but he was there. Lyricists, and the future of the band may have seemed a little, you know, up in the air or whatever, but they really came back strong with Everything Must Go. It's an amazing album. Rich, of course, is thought to have jumped from the bridge. What is it? It's near Newport. It's where you drive from the English side of the Bristol Channel and Bristol area across to Wales. And they waited many years. They kept paying royalties to his family, and I think he was declared dead finally. Was it around 2010? Somewhere around that, it was around, I think it was around the time when they did that that album, Plague Lovers, where they used all their lyrics they had lying around from him. So yeah, There's a really nice booklet in here. It shows, among other things, they released a lot of singles from this album, and in various versions. And so a lot of that art in here, as well as, vinyl. Here's the content, and as you can see, here are the CDs as well as DVDs. This is all great, and I love this album and this box set, but the Manics really do jump from box set to box set style. They're all over the place. Next one, also whales, super furry animals, mung, Welsh word means mane. This, their fourth album, is entirely in Welsh, and after the very, very expensive third album, which did not do as well as one would have hoped, the record company folded, Creation, I think it was, and they had to rethink things, and they ended up recording this for, I think, a fraction of the price. It became a fairly big success, especially with the critics, and it was mentioned in Parliament. It's all part of Cool Cymru, and it's the highest selling Welsh language album in US history. Number four, Pearl Jam. No Code, their fourth album. Back then, a very big departure from what they had done so far. Pearl Jam is one of my absolute favorite bands. Why do I have two? Well, actually, I have three because they had to send me an extra copy because there was a big, rip or whatever in the vinyl. And one of these is the regular bought through their through Amazon, and the other one is one that I have bought through their website, which is in Cove Green, and I absolutely love this album. So, if by some miracle you have come to my page and not seen Robert's channel, please do so, subscribe, and give him a word from me, and I'll leave some links in the description, and I hope you enjoy this. I hope you will like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon in another video. 8 minutes.